starting with the floral diagram of the Solanaceae family. The morphological description of Solanaceae family we had already discussed in the previous video. So let's start the floral diagram with the mother axis. Next to the mother axis, there is a presence of the all different floral whorls in a circular arrangement. This arrangement is typically called as the aestivation. As the flower is a pentamerous, let's divide the circle in 5 equal halves. So let's start with the outermost floral whorls, that is calyx, which is represented by the sepal. First sepal, second, the third sepal, the next one is the fourth one, and the last one is the fifth. So as the floral diagram represents the sepals by the arc with the pointed arrow, so this has a specific shape which we had already discussed in a previous video, of which the links are given in the description box. So this sign is a represent the structure of sepal. As the sepals do not overlap on one another, they are arranged in a circular pattern without overlapping. That means the aestivation is velvet. The velvet aestivation represented by the sepals. The next one is the petals. The petals are the unit of the corolla and it is alternate to the sepals. The arrangement of the petals are alternate to the sepals. The first petal, this one is the second, third, fourth, and the fifth petal. So these petals are also arranged in velvet aestivation and it is alternate to the sepals. As the Solanaceae family shows the gamosepalous and gamopetalous condition, therefore we are putting a loop in between the sepals and petals. Therefore the floral diagram represents the gamosepalous and the gamopetalous condition in the floral diagram. In the previous video we already discussed about the floral formula. The floral formula of the Solanaceae family is eubracteate, actinomorphic symmetry, bisexual, calyx sepals are 5 and a gamosepalous, corolla petals are 5 and gamopetalous, androecium 5 and polyandrous condition, while the gynoecium 2 and in some family it is a syncarpus and in some members it is the polycarpus. The next floral whorl in the floral diagram is the androecium, which is represented by the stamen and the anther itself, and which is also the alternate to the petals. Therefore we are drawing the anthers, which is a dithecus. That's why we are making the dithecus representing sign of this anther. These dithecus anthers are freely arranged, but there is a fusion between the petals and the androecium, which is called as a epipetalous condition. This epipetalous condition is a characteristic feature of the Solanaceae family. Next one is the gynoecium, which is a bicarpillary. In this case the carpel shows the swollen placenta, and on the swollen placenta the number of ovules are arranged in each locule. The ovary is a bilocular and the placentation are freely arranged on the swollen placenta. These ovules are arranged. So this is the floral diagram of the Solanaceae family.